When I was like 10, like my mom has like pretty small feet. So I could like fit into her shoes like real well, cause she like wears like a slim size 7. So I was just like, oh my God, girl. Like I was just like all up in Marilyn's closet, throwing on the shoes, throwing on like the robes and the furs. And like we had this mirror that was in, in our dining room that I would go and take, like unhang it from the wall. And then put it underneath the mantle, like in front of the fireplace in the living room, and then walk the entire length of the house in my mom's heels, practicing my runway at the tender age of 10. I remember when she was at the finale, she said that she was just like, there was such a love energy in that room. I feel like she fully understood the correlation between her as a reverend in church culture. I feel like she saw the similarities there, and like felt like she became comfortable and knew that I belonged to a community that was like about fostering like love. It's great to know that like my mom is like being pushed into this like understanding of queer culture. She's just like so open-hearted and just so full of love. Like my mom loves the fans. She loves the kids. She's just like such a mama. She just like loves that there's like all these crops of like kids that can just like feel love, because like that's, she just thinks that it's just like so great. My fan base are Gucci lovers. That's just like, that's it. That's like literally, that's just like 9 times out of 10, if they're a Shea Coulee fan, they probably got Gucci on somewhere. It's like the fanny pack or like the t-shirt. Like I swear to God, like I just like fucking love y'all. Y'all are just like so Gucci to me all the time. And I just like live. You guys got great taste. My fans got impeccable taste. Like my fans like know, you know, like, not only do y'all support me and like lift a bitch up, but like also like y'all are like mad cool. Every time I meet a fan, like you guys are just like so awesome. And you all love Gucci. My number one fan is this girl, Natty. She's an Aquarius like myself. She lives in Manhattan. She's this cute little biracial little, just cutie little, just like she's, but you know what? I'm not gonna talk about her that much because she also has an attitude problem. She low-key knows that she's my number one fan. But you know, but that's like the Shea Coulee attitude too. Like she knows she's that bitch. Like, of course my number one fan is like that girl that's just all like, y'all bum bitches aren't shit. You know, that's her. To be my number one stan, she is definitely on brand. So shout out to you, Natty. Whenever I have an opportunity to meet a fan who is a person of color and says that my drag inspires them or makes them feel confident, that's just like so rewarding. Especially when it's a black woman who says, you inspire me to be like my best, to be like the best woman I can be. It just is so humbling and amazing. Like, that's honestly the best compliment I could get from anyone.
That's amazing.
Right? This is actually my first time trying this outfit on, so I'm like, so you're seeing like my first reactions to these looks too. So it's a lot of me being like, ooh. My social media was hacked by someone who
felt that it would be appropriate to post pictures of slaves and tag them as my family with the hashtag niggers. So definitely my experience in being hacked was a direct reflection of someone's racist feelings towards me. Someone who I've never even met.
When dealing with issues of race and drag culture, it's all part of the experience, you know? Drag queens are marginalized people. And so, you know, I feel like being a drag queen of color almost helps to enrich your art, even that it gives it so much more depth because of the experiences that you have just in being who you are. That's just the industry. That's just the world that we live in, you know? I love being black. I would never, ever give it up for anything. Even with all the struggles and the bullshit and all the like whack assness that comes along with like the oppression that exists around my existence, I still feel so powerful each and every day in who I am. And that just, you know, lends itself to my art. And you know what? Not everyone's gonna get it, and that is okay. But there are people out there I know that understand like my point of view and feel a certain kind of way about it, and it touches some part of them. And I just know that I'm here for a reason, exactly the way that I am. And so all I know how to do is do me, and that's just all I'm gonna do. I don't believe in not taking care of the people that take care of you. I think it's just, you know, principle. And with that comes a lot of hard work. It's not easy trying to be dignified and do right by people and making sure that the people that are there for you along the way, that you're helping to bring them up at the same time. But that's the only way that I know how to do it, because I'm no bum boss, you know? I'm a boss bitch.
I'm gonna go backstage, but I'm gonna switch into something a little bit less comfortable. And we are gonna fuck this show up. Are you guys ready?